to hide. I don't know if you live with friends and who you can confide. I don't know if you got a family, say a mom or dad. I don't know if you feel love at all, but I bet you wish you had. Come and go with me to my father's house. Come and go with me to my father's house. It's a big, big house with lots and lots of room.
Good morning and welcome to Elk River Lutheran Church. I'm Pastor Nathan, and we are happy to be joining you here in a little different setting. You may have noticed that we're not in the sanctuary here this morning, but outside. It's Memorial Day weekend, and so I'm guessing many of you are getting out and about, maybe not with your regular Memorial Day activities, but hopefully maybe you're getting out and about a little bit. And so we're going to incorporate the Memorial Day theme into our service here today as we gather this morning online. And as we gather here online, our theme for this morning is hope. And we're going to read a passage from John chapter 6, In My Father's House. And so as we gather here, let's introduce the crew here as who's here. So
I'm Lisa Sampson. I'm the Director of Children, Youth, and Family Ministry.
And Nathan Lugas, Pastor, once again.
Jeremy Holquist, Minister of Congregational Care and Discipleship.
And I'm Taylor Quinn, the Director of Music and Worship.
And we are glad that you are with us wherever you are finding us here this morning. We are online and glad to be with you. So our service here today is going to be somewhat like a normal service, except for our setting's a little different, our music's a little different. So maybe it is a little bit of a different service, but the core pieces are here. And so as we start on this Memorial Day weekend, you know, camping is kind of a big thing that people do on Memorial Day weekend often. Memorial Day is, of course, a day to remember those who died, especially those who have died in service to this country. But it is also, and we are going to reflect on that here today, but it is also kind of the unofficial start of summer. And so that's why we gathered in lawn chairs here this morning. And so one question just for a discussion to start us off is just, I'm curious if you all are campers. Are you people who camp either as childhood or adulthood or anywhere in between?
Adulthood, yeah.
Okay.
Boundary waters, canoer. Camping is good.
Yeah.
We had a cabin growing up for our family, and so that was, I always think of Memorial Day weekend as the time that we put in the dock.
Which was fun.
And it was frigid and cold. And the water, we were on Eagle Lake, and the water is like crystal clear up by Battle Lake area, and it was so cold. But everyone was excited to put the dock in.
I used to camp a lot when I was a kid. I'm a Boy Scout, and so camping is part of, obviously, that tradition. And so I grew up camping all the time, whether it's Boundary Waters or with Scouts. And we had kids, and that kind of went out the window because it's hard to take kids camping at this age. So.
Yeah. Yeah, my family growing up had a pickup camper when I was really young, and then an old motorhome, and that's just so fun. There's just something about camping in that whole kind of campground kind of life that's just a little different, so that's fun. Well, part of it is our campfire, which is not exactly raging at this point, but it is sure smoking well. And so I hope you can smell this. If you're at home there, you can smell the smell of campfire that we are being filled with as we gather here. But we're going to do some camp-style music here this morning. And so what's the first song we're doing?
I Will Call Upon the Lord, The Rock.
Okay. slip my notes up here too.
So if you know it, join in at home.
You bet.
Do a little bit of actions and have a lot of fun.
Yep.
Yeah.
Lisa will lead the actions. Just kidding.
I'll make them up.
I know. Do you know?
Kind of.
Okay. Rusty.
All right.
1, 2, 3, go.
I will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from my enemies, right? The Lord liveth, and blessed be the rock, and may the God of our salvation be exalted. The Lord liveth, and blessed be the rock, and may the God of our salvation be exalted. I will call upon the right? The Lord liveth, and blessed be the rock, and may the God of our salvation be, I'll take it, exalted. The Lord liveth, and blessed be the rock, and may the God of our salvation be exalted.
Nice.
Yeah. Well, so our scripture reading, you know, like I said, our theme is In My Father's House. We're doing this Home Alone sermon series, stories of God showing up at home. And this is not so much a story, but it's a teaching of Jesus, this scripture reading from John chapter 14. It's verses 1 through 7 that we'll have here this morning. And it is a passage that is about, it's often read at funerals, it really is about eternity and this eternal heavenly home, not just the homes that you're maybe in today. Lisa, you wanted to be our reader here this morning?
Sure. From John 14, 1 through 7. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, you will know my Father also. From now on, you do know him and you have seen him. Amen.
Well, so it is Memorial Day weekend, and I've actually, I think, shared at church before, so some of you have maybe heard. We share a little bit of the memorial tradition that we had in my hometown growing up, and it was kind of a big deal, Memorial Day was, because I grew up in this little town, Sherwood, North Dakota, way up on the Canadian border, and every Memorial Day, veterans from Sherwood and the surrounding area would meet Canadian veterans up at the Canadian border. They would do a little kind of, you know, I don't know what they did exactly. You know, they met at the border and then they marched down together to the Sherwood Gym. So they marched 2 miles down to the Sherwood Gymnasium, and there was a joint program, this Canadian and American program, where different veterans would speak and, you know, share stories. And I mean, it was just a beautiful and fitting Memorial Day tribute that, I mean, I've only grown to appreciate more, you know, as I get older. And I mean, there's funny things like that's how I learned all the words to O Canada and God Save the Queen and all those Canadian songs, right along with all the American patriotic songs, because as kids we'd sing there each year. But you know, just those stories and the practice of remembering was just so strong in that event that still goes on. And so I was just wondering if any of you or any of you at home too, do you have specific Memorial Day traditions or ways of honoring people who served our country?
Yep, in Evansville, we always, that Monday, It was the high school did a marching band, and we always got together, and we did a parade, actually, because we have a cemetery in Evansville. Yeah. We would always, I mean, every year we would do a parade down there. It was always raining, but it was a thing.
Sure. I don't think we had, a specific practice. I mean, it was mostly get together with people and sort of celebrate. But I always have this, weird, fond memory of my dad took me to the Vietnam Wall when I was a kid. Mm-hmm. And he always tells the story of, running your hands across a name. It was the guy who took his seat the day he took a vacation day. And that man was killed, obviously. But that the image and the feeling of running your hands across that wall, for me, was this moment of, I will always remember that, and this holiday always sort of brings that to mind. Remember his story.
Yeah. So. And growing up, I grew up having a cabin, and we would open it up Memorial Day weekend before we'd move up there as soon as school. We'd move up there lock, stock, and barrel, live there all summer.
Sure.
After school was out. But when my kids were in high school, they were in the marching band at Cambridge Isandy High School, and they always did a Memorial Day parade at one of the cemeteries or wherever, and so that kind of became more meaningful then.
Yeah, I always remember going to the cemetery on Memorial Day or right before Memorial Day so that there would be flowers on all the graves as well. Yeah, those kind of rituals of remembering are good and important. You know, Memorial Day is also just a time in general to remember loved ones who died. This text, John 14, is a text that's, actually, in my experience, really commonly used at funerals. I think we read John 14 at funerals. Of all the funerals I've done, I think read this text more often than even Psalm 23, because there is just such beautiful promise in it. And so, what do you think does make this text, John 14, such a good fit for funerals? Why is it chosen so often? Thoughts?
I think the part of it that hits me the deepest is I am the way, the truth, and the life. Just that part, no one comes to the Father except for me. I think it just gives hope that, I don't know. I mean, I don't know why it's a harder, deeper sense that even when we pass away, we don't know exactly where we're, well, we do know where we're going. But it's nice to have that kind of comfort. I don't know, death just kind of brings in front of us this sense that there's a mystery to it, even if you have a faith. It's kind of nice to have something in writing to be reiterated, this is where you're going, and you can have peace with that.
The verse that I really like is that I go to prepare a place for you. That means that it's already going to happen. I don't have to worry about it. It's prepared and it's there. And I think that brings a lot of comfort. I know that, my dad died 3 years ago, and I know I'm not so bothered by it. He lived a great, full life, but I know I'll see him again in that place that has been prepared for me and all of us.
I love the intention of God and Jesus here, where, I prepare a place for you so that where I am, there you may be also. Mm-hmm. That, it gets at God's heart is to be with us. And we experience that in many ways in this life, even being out in creation like we are right now. But the promise that's here is of just a pure presence of God that is just, that's the promise of heaven. It's beautiful, yeah.
But I think death is often lonely, right? I mean, that people die alone, they experience death. After death, we feel alone, we feel lost. And I think the sense that God accompanies us in those spaces, right? We're not abandoned by death. Death doesn't have the final say. I think that's that one nugget of hope, is that whatever this experience is post this life, that I'm not going by myself. And I think that's hopeful, that's promising.
It's hard to accept death as a part of life. I was talking to one of my singer ladies, and her husband's passing away. He's dying of kidney cancer, something like that. Bladder cancer. And she said, it's so easy to rejoice in the miracle of birth, because you think it's a miracle, and you know, and you get this thing to take home with you, it's tangible. But death is different, because you don't get to take anything home, you're losing something. And yet it's part of our life, you know. I just thought that's kind of a deep thinking.
Yeah.
Just a thought that death is part of our life, you know.
My CPE instructor asked if you could die anyway, would you have a preference? And we don't need to answer that question. It's kind of morbid.
Kind of a dark question. But
right, but I think
yeah.
to think about, death is an experience, and death is something that we can kind of set the parameters for the most part. I mean, how we choose to go on and how we choose to leave that memory with people, that's just the next step in our process and the next step in who we are as people. But I think it's interesting to think about our space around death, whether it's fear or worry or anxiousness, but then to think about it also as hopeful. I mean, there's something beyond this.
Yeah.
At least for us that believe in hope and that there's something better that we can hold on to.
Well, so this Memorial Day weekend, in its namesake, is about remembering, which is, you know, also always a big part of a funeral service, is remembering. And you remember the person who's died, what they loved, their little quirks and funny stories, sad stories. You know, it's all of that remembering kind of wrapped up in one. And this holiday, Memorial Day, it was started to remember. And so, I mean, we kind of hinted at some of these things, but why is it important for us to remember? Like, why is remembering life in the midst of death important?
I think it's a sense of honoring. And to honor somebody's memory is to hold them in such a sacred place. And I think to think good on them, no matter the situation, in some ways. But it holds them in a place of, this is a person who lived a beautiful life on Earth, and to hold that space for them is great.
Just remember their importance. I've always loved Gettysburg. I've always loved the idea of Civil War. I don't have really many people in my family or know any veterans, but when we went to Gettysburg with the choir boys, it just kind of hit me, you know. Significant things happen in our lives in those moments. And also, I think going to Washington, D.C. and walking the Mall was kind of impactful for me, because it helped me, it brought me back to the reason why these men and women fight, have fought, or continue to fight. And just the act of remembering kind of, it centers me and reminds me that there's something greater out there than just me, and people have died for how I can live now, you know?
Yeah, well, I would really encourage everyone, I think all of us will be practicing this, if you haven't taken time to really remember this week, this weekend, do that. That is a big part of what this weekend is all about, is taking time to remember, and that takes some intentionality in the midst of putting in docks and, you know, having barbecues and, you know, doing all those things. Taking time to remember is important. So we'll continue now with a special song, so let's go ahead and listen to that.
Good brother, good comfort.
so we're going to continue with a time of prayer. And during this time of prayer, we're going to play and sing a song, Sanctuary. And during this song, we invite you to share prayer concerns either via the link to our website that is on elkriverlutheran.org or else in the comments there. Share prayer concerns and just find a time and a place of prayer in your heart as well as we continue with some prayer. Sanctuary.
Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true, with thanksgiving.
Thanks for everyone who has served and who has died in the name of war. But we lift them before you, their memory, their hopes, their dreams. But we entrust those people to your loving care as we celebrate this season, as we remember. But remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. On earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Well, this time we have our offering, our virtual offering. So we want to thank you for all the ways you, over the years and in this time, have given to support Elk River Lutheran Church. We are so grateful for your partnership in ministry. And if you are able at this time to make a financial gift to the church, you can do that via the link on the website, by mailing a check to the church, or by stopping here at the church and dropping off an offering in the locked mailbox. We know that that's not possible for everyone. That some of you are facing some financial hardships with all that's going on, and we completely understand that and wish you well. And for those of you who are able to still support the church, we thank you. The mission, the ministry of the church continues on, even in different ways. This feels pretty different here today. But for all of your love and support, we thank you. And so as we go, receive this blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let's end with My Lighthouse.
All right, let's see if our fingers can keep up.
See if I remember the words. Oh, yeah.
In my wrestling and in my doubts, in my failures, my
silence.
In my silence, you won't let go. In the question, your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Oh, you are the peace in my troubled sea.
Thank you for joining us online here today. Go in peace. Share the good news.
We will.
Thanks be to God.
God bless everybody. Happy Memorial Day weekend.
Big house, lots and lots of room. A big, big table, lots and lots of food. A big, big yard where we can play football. A big, big house. It's my father's house.
Nailed it.
But we're in A, that's right.